Who pays the cost of money? It is our common man, the middle class, the guy who buys the apartment. It is he who bears that burden. Why don't we realize that part? We must look into this. I want to say, because there are a lot of planners, there are a lot of students also from planning here, I want to say that we must look into our past. Thousands of years ago, in our Atharva Veda, there is a shloka. It is under chapter 20, it is under chapter 9, Sukta 3 and Mantra 24. Om Kulay Adi Kulayam Koshe Kosha Samujyate Yatrat Mantro Vijayate Yasmad Vishwam Prajayate. ओम कुलायम कुलाय, जैसे पक्षी घोंसले के ऊपर घोंसला बनाता है, कोशे कोशा समुज्यते, यू शुड ट्राई टू क्रिएट हाउसिंग ओवर हाउसिंग. दिस इज व्हाट वाज टॉक्ड लॉन्ग टाइम बिफोर, एंड इवन टुडे आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस वी टॉक अबाउट स्प्रॉलिंग एंड हॉरिजॉन्टल डेवलपमेंट, सिंगल स्टोरी, डबल स्टोरी, लॉट ऑफ प्लॉटेड, एंड व्हाइल वी हैव सो मच ऑफ एक्सेसिव पॉपुलेशन हियर. यत्र तंत्र मंत्रो विजायते यस्माद विषयम प्रजायते. योर हाउसिंग शुड, ईच हाउस होल्ड मस्ट प्रोटेक्ट द वर्ल्ड एज हिज ओन सिबलिंग. सो दिस इज द एक्चुअली हाउसिंग, सस्टेनेबल हाउसिंग फॉर मासेस. दिस इज व्हाट इज द नेम विच हैज बीन ड्रॉन, सस्टेनेबल हाउसिंग फॉर मासेस फ्रॉम आवर अथर्ववेद. आई वुड गिव स्मॉल एग्जाम्पल्स हाउ देर आर लॉट ऑफ डिफिकल्टीज and how we can sit together and find solution. I have been running around to make people sit on the table. Ministry of Housing also has been doing its best, and in the latest last some time we have seen actually tangible meaningful results happening in the ministry, and I am very hopeful that it is a time for change. The change is happening now. Ministry of Environment, in 1994, till 1994, there was no clearance, environment clearance required for housing projects. In 2004, suddenly the housing projects were brought under clearance process. And 2006, notification was issued that you have to get your housing projects individually cleared from the Ministry of Environment, where they constituted state-wise 10-member committees and 3-member authorities, you know, which will clear the processes, and takes between almost 2 years before we get environment clearance. And it is surprising to see that in same master plan, there are same 6-7 conditions which are copied and pasted after running around each and every individual and each and every table, and then ultimately you get the same thing. Why we cannot clear the master plans? Why the master plans are not given environment clearance? Similarly, there is a height clearance by Airport Authority of India. I have been trying to bring them also in this convention, but unfortunately I failed. Today is the day of technology. You also clear buildings based upon your funnel, based upon your path of the aircrafts. Why cannot this be put on a software which is available with the Town and Country Planning Department, and they can clear projects online? So this is a very simple process. We need not wait for more than 1 year to get height clearance for buildings, you know. So there are so many things which have been created at every point. Wherever some government agency finds there is a way to intervene, they are intervening, and that is causing delays in the projects, that is causing delivery. I would request that we should make use of technology. We should set standard guidelines. We should create committees for clearing, you know, title process. We can take consultants, title process, for financial capability process, for architectural requirement process. These can be master plan to master plan. These things can be standardized, put online, and we can be made to get clearances. Once these architects and everybody has certified that the things are conforming to the infrastructure available, which is created under the master plan by the state, be able to get our projects for mass housing cleared online itself with a minimum financial burden and minimum time lag. I would thank the Honorable Minister Shri Ajay Makan ji, who is giving his best efforts to see that the basic requirements, that is creating affordable guidelines for the housing sector, creating online clearance process, which I have requested now, is also almost finalized, those guidelines for the states, and also to work to get tax incentives for creating affordable housing. All these efforts are actually at the very advanced stage, and I think we are very likely to get some good news in this respect, that the common man might be able to get housing. I, at the last, want to really thank Honorable President Saab, who has taken his valuable time, and I would like that this effort should not be just one another effort of such conferences which keep on happening every year, and we must sit down together, try to bring, everybody should come on the table with an open mind, with a mind to change this country, with a mind to work together to see that this mission is accomplished. Thank you very much.
I'd now like to invite Sunil Daya, Senior Vice President NAREDCO, to welcome the President and present a memento. Ladies and gentlemen, our next speaker is a man that we've all pinned our hopes on. The new Minister for Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation, Ajay Makan. The young Mr. Makan brings with him fresh hopes of change. That he is a man in a hurry is clearly visible. In less than 45 days of taking charge, he's already launched the Credit Risk Guarantee Fund, has looked into the recommendations of liberalizing norms for greater floor area ratio and popular density.
His Excellency, Honorable President of India, dignitaries on the dais, leaders of reality sector present, media persons, ladies and gentlemen. I am happy to be here today at the 11th National Convention of National Real Estate Development Council. Your Excellency, the Honorable President of India, with your presence here, we all feel deeply motivated. Thank you for your warm support to this sector. NAREDCO's 11th National Convention on Sustainable Housing for Masses is timely and appropriate in the light of government's focus on providing affordable housing for all. India's urban population in 2011 was 377.11 million, 31.16% of the total population of the country. It is projected that by 2021, the urban population could be 473 million, and by 2041, a whopping 700 million. With rapid urbanization, sustainable housing supply is expected to pose greater challenges in the days to come, more so for the low-income group and the poor. As per the technical committee constituted by my ministry, shortage of housing at present stands at 18.78 million, out of which nearly 96% is in the economically weaker section and lower income group categories. Provision of houses to all the citizens thus requires for sustained efforts by both government and at the central and state level and also the private stakeholders. World Commission of Environment and Development defines sustainable development as development which meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generation to meet their own needs. In order to ensure sustainable development, builders, architects, designers, community planners, and real estate developers must strive to create buildings and communities that will not deplete natural resources. The goal is to meet today's needs using renewable resources so that needs of future generations would be provided for sustainable development. We must attempt to minimize greenhouse gases, reduce global warming, preserve environmental resources, and provide communities that allow people to reach their fullest potentials. Under the National Action Plan for Climate Change, The National Mission on Sustainable Habitat has been approved as one of the 8 missions by our Honorable Prime Minister in 2010. The Mission on Sustainable Habitat aims to make cities sustainable through improvements in energy efficiency, in building, management of solid waste, and model shift to public transport. This mission promotes energy efficiency as an essential module of urban planning and urban renewal. The National Urban Housing and Habitat Policy of 2007 has been formulated with affordable housing for all as a goal. This policy has been a major catalyst for improvement and effective growth of our cities. The goal of affordable housing for all, with special emphasis on EWS, LIG and MIG segments, is something we all have to strive for. The policy encourages a multi-pronged approach to tackle the problems unique to each economic segment. Jawaharlal Nehru Urban Renewal Mission, launched in December 2005, was a path-breaking initiative to address the urban sector's issues as a reform-oriented program.